Problem number 15 from Hall and Knight Higher Algebra Chapter 1 Ratios. We have been given this relationship to be true, okay, and we have to prove this expression. We have to prove this, okay. Now, let us say that we'll label each of these equations. Let us say that this term is 1, this term is 2, and this term is 3. What we can do is, we can write term 1 as, term 1 can be written as my plus nz minus lx divided by 1 over L. Okay, what I have done is, because you can see L over here, if I want to take it down to the denominator, we have to simply divide it by 1 over L. So 2 can be written as nz plus lx minus my divided by 1 over m. And the third term can be written as lx plus my minus nz over 1 over m. Now suppose if each of these terms was equal to k, that is, if this was equal to k, this term over here was equal to k, and this term over here was equal to k, then each of these terms will also be equal to k. Okay, this k is some arbitrary constant, we don't know the value, but we are just putting it so that it is easier for us to track what the value of each of the terms is. Now once we have this, why we have done all this is because we wanted to somehow get y plus z minus x in the numerator. It will not necessarily get us here directly, but I was hoping that arranging this term like this and trying to solve it with this arrangement will simplify this equation. So let us say if each of these ratios now, because now this is a ratio, this is a ratio of, we have something, some term in numerator and we have a denominator, so each of these terms is a ratio, okay. So if each of these ratios is equal to k, okay, each of these ratios are equal and this is equal to k, then 1 plus 2 should also be equal to k, okay. Now let us add the numerators of 1 and 2. We can see that minus lx will cancel, minus lx will cancel with plus lx, my will cancel with minus my, and we get 2 times nz. We add the denominators also, we get 1 by l plus 1 by n. Now just simplify the denominator, you get 2 times nz m plus l over ln. Now this ln can be taken to the numerator, so you get 2 times L M N times Z over L plus M, and this is equal to K. Okay. Similarly, if we do 2 plus 3, okay, that is if we add these two equation, we can again see that my will cancel with minus my, nz will cancel out, and you will be left with 2 times lx. Okay, you can do all the simplification, and in the end you will get 2 times ln x over m plus n. This will be equal to k. And if we add 3 plus 1, okay, we are adding this and this, we can see that lx will cancel out, nz will cancel out, and you will be left with 2 times my. So finally you will get 2 times lmny over n plus l is equal to k. So what we have got so far is, let me write it again, what we have got is 2 times lm n x over m plus n, which is this term, is equal to 2 times lm n y over n plus l, which is this term, is equal to 2 times lm n z over l plus m, which is this term. All this is equal to k. Now if you multiply divide this by 2 times lmn, what you get is x over m plus n is equal to y over n plus l is equal to z over l plus m, and this is equal to k over 2 times lmn. We can call this some other constant, say called k1. Okay, because the value of this constant is not important. The relationship between x, y, z and m and l is important. This is only for keeping track of what each of these ratios is equal to. So we are now calling each of these ratios as k1, and these ratios and this relationship look simpler than what we had before. Now using this relationship, okay, using this relationship we can prove what we want to prove, that is y plus z minus x over l. How can we get y plus z? We can add, now again let us label it. Now this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. Okay, now these are new labels. So how to get y plus z from these two? So if we add 2 and 3 and subtract 1, we can get y plus z minus x. So 2 plus 3 minus 1 is equal to y plus z minus x. Okay, you have 2l plus n plus m minus m minus n. So in the end you will have only 2l over here. Okay, similarly what will be 3 plus 1 minus 2. Okay, 3 plus 1 minus 2 will give us z plus x minus y. We have L plus M plus M plus N. So we have 2M and N and L will cancel out. So this will be 2M. And 1 plus 2 minus 3 will give you x plus y minus z is equal to over 2m. Okay, so now each of these ratios is equal to what? Each of these ratios is equal to k1. This is also equal to k1. This is also equal to k1. So finally what we have is, what we have is y plus z minus x over 2l is equal to z plus x minus y over 2m is equal to x plus y minus z over 2n is equal to k1. Now you can multiply each of these ratios by 2 and you will end up with what we wanted to prove. Okay, so you will get y plus z minus x over l will be equal to z plus x minus y over m is equal to x plus y minus z over n. Each of these ratios is equal and they will be equal to 2 times k1. And we are done.